Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte says the money the government borrowed to fund its vaccine rollout is still with the banks. In his late night address on Monday, Duterte said the government did not hold any of the money as cold cash. Duterte was responding to criticism that the country's vaccine procurement was too slow. Last week, Senator Panfilo Lacson asked where the COVID-19 vaccines were, considering the country has borrowed more than 100 billion pesos for the rollout.
If you are afraid of corruption, let your mind go easy, because these things are not susceptible to anything. The money is in the hands of the bank, and they collect yung nagpabili sa atin ng bakuna from the bank. It's the bank who will pay upon our advice na na-deliver na yung bakuna. Hindi tayo ang magpunta.
So far, the Philippines has only received 1.125 million doses of the Sinovac and AstraZeneca vaccines. They were donated by China and the World Health Organization's COVAX facility. The Philippine government will no longer distribute financial aid like it did during the start of the COVID-19 pandemic, despite fresh restrictions in Metro Manila and its surrounding provinces. Some businesses in the National Capital Region, Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal, are forced to suspend or limit their operations until April 4th due to the rise in new COVID-19 cases. Malacanang spokesman Harry Roque said the government cannot afford to put the country under the stricter enhanced or modified enhanced community quarantine. He said it can only offer loans or emergency employment.
Pero in terms of yung sinasabi mong ayuda na gaya ng binigay natin sa ECQ, dahil hindi naman po natin pinipigil magtrabaho ang ating mga kababayan, eh hindi na po tayo dapat magbigay ng ganung ayuda dahil pwede po maghanap buhay ang lahat. Pero I understand yung mga local governments po, yung mga subject to localized and granular, nagbibigay po rin sila ng ayuda.
The Philippines logs a fresh record high of over 8,000 new COVID-19 cases. Worst health officials confirm the more contagious coronavirus variants are present in all cities here in Metro Manila. Christine Sabilla reports.
For the third time in 4 days, the Philippines registered a record high number of new COVID-19 cases. Health officials on Monday reported 8,019 new infections. Total active cases are now at more than 80,000, the second highest since the pandemic began. Two laboratories were unable to submit data on time. What's even more concerning is the announcement that the more transmissible variants are now in every city in the National Capital Region.
Talagang nakita na natin itong mga variants eh nasa lahat na ng cities dito sa atin sa Metro Manila. Meron na tayong it's either the UK variant or the South African variant. Also in other cities, meron na siya both UK variant and South African variant.
Sa lagay naman po ng bawat rehiyon sa bansa na nananatiling nasa high risk, ang NCR base sa naitalang 2-week growth rate nito na 137% at average daily attack rate na 14.90 per 100,000 population, habang ang regions 2, 3, 4, A, and 6 po at Caraga ay nasa moderate risk.
The DOH has yet to release a breakdown of variant cases per city in Metro Manila. But for the whole country, government data show the most number of South African variant cases at 105 in the region. NCR is also second to returning overseas Filipinos for the tally of UK variant cases. Currently, there are 223 UK variant cases, 152 South African variant cases, 1 Brazil variant case, and 104 P.3 variant cases in the Philippines. Majority of them have already recovered, although more than 100 are still active cases. While the variant cases are increasing, the health department says it is still hard to say if there is already community transmission of the variants.
Kami ay humihingi ng tulong sa WHO para sila ang makapagbigay sa atin ng guidance and confirmation if there really is local transmission or community transmission of these variants.
While variants are a factor in the increase of cases, the health department says there are other root causes.
That would be yung ating compliance sa health protocols natin and of course some institutional gaps na meron po tayo.
Based on government data analyzed by the ABS-CBN Investigative and Research Group, most cities in the NCR have doubled or more than tripled their number of active cases in the past 2 weeks. This include Quezon City, Manila, Marikina, Mandaluyong, San Juan, and Caloocan. The areas that did not see that significant of an increase are Pasay, which already imposed localized lockdowns, Valenzuela, Malabon, and Navotas. Active cases also more than doubled in the nearby provinces of Cavite, Bulacan, Rizal, and Laguna. The health department insists the government is doing its job, which now includes house-to-house checking of suspect COVID-19 cases for isolation and quarantine. Christine Sabilio, ABS-CBN News.